The things that they tried to make it look like they're transistor fossils, they found out those were hoaxes. So now, here, you have this individual saying no transistor forms. Then, even on the molecular level, you get a 2018, in May 2018, you find these evolutions that have found, okay, Dr. Thaler says, they have something called a gene bank. People continue to put different species into a universal bank that can be accessed to see how these genetic forms have come about. Well, they found something called, or they invented something called the gene gun, but it's a barcoding system where they could actually go to the mitochondria, not inside the cell, but the mitochondria that supplies the ATP. So here, they can actually go back, barcode this, and actually see the universal common descent all the way back. That's pretty good. You know what they found? They said, even with their wrong year calculations, it stopped at 100,000 years. Wait a minute. What was that all about? And all of the species came about at the same time. That wasn't supposed to happen either. So here's what we have. He says here, the majority of the animal life originated around the same time as the humans, and that there was evidence of intermediate, excuse me, there was a lack of evidence between the intermediates between species. So co-author Dr. Thaler stated frankly that the absence of in-between species, absence means there was none, is something that also perplexed Darwin. He just said the same thing. See, but he's doing it now on a molecular level. So whether you're looking fossils or whether you're looking at the genome, there's no evidence at all that these things transition through billions of years of random processes. So what's your conclusion? If random processes had no hand in the law-like order of the universe, and you have, who do you think, or what do you think would be the cause of the complexity of the human body today? You have an idea on that? It does need a designer or creator. Who do you think he is?
The Almighty God.
He is the Almighty God. And now, the next thing I would ask is, okay, there's a few, claims, of different religious ideas, but there's only one idea that matches this kind of evidence, where the Almighty God, who designed all of this, wrote a history book before the history happened. In other words, he gave hundreds of detailed prophecies about where he would be born, what he would do when he came to earth, why he would do it. Psalm 22 says how he would be executed, said his hands and his feet would be pierced. Psalm 22 verse 16. The reason God did that is so that when you and I are saying Almighty God, we're not in some vague space here. But he hasn't revealed himself. He actually did reveal himself.
Jesus Christ.
That's exactly right. The one who fulfilled those prophecies was indeed the Lord Jesus Christ. So now you know he's a promise-keeping God, not only one who put his fingerprints all over creation, but the one who also, in time, fulfilled the prophecies that completely identified him alone. Now that you know he makes promises, then the next question you and I should ask is he making me a promise? It's a fair question, isn't it? So do you know of any promises directly that the Lord Jesus Christ is making to you? There's a really big one I have in mind. Can I tell you what it is? Good. He says, behold, I stand at the door and knock. If anyone hears my voice, you'll hear his voice. You will open the door. He's waiting to come in. If you open the door, you know what he says he'll do? He'll come in. See, because that is such good news, I don't want you to think that that's just my opinion. So I always like to make sure that people have the ability to see, all the evidence we're talking about here, right in the creation, right with the fulfilled prophecy, and then you see that it's even right here. He says, the old
man.
Any person, hear my voice. If you open the door, I'll promise you I'll come in. I'll come into that person. We'll sup together. You won't be separate anymore, because those iniquities that separated you from me, I'll lay them all on you. We'll all be like sheep that have gone astray. Old Testament, 700 years before Christ. Promise keeping God says this: all we like sheep have gone astray. We have turned everyone to his own way, and the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all. Back to verse 6 in verse 11, the same chapter, he says, he shall see of the travail of his soul and shall be satisfied. By his knowledge shall my righteous servant justify many, for he shall bear their iniquities. So here is the statement of God. God says, there are absolutes. I create mathematical absolutes. There's more, there's material absolutes, but there's moral absolutes.
Take him off.